To all my friends, today we learn how to estimate the quantity of RCC beam now. Okay, so here is the problem. So we have to estimate the quantity of RCC means concrete and steel separately. So here this is the problem. L section, longitudinal section of the beam is given. And this is the cross section, 8 meter clear span is mentioned here. So here it is the cross section, 75 by 40 centimeter. Okay, so this is the problem. We have to estimate the quantity of RCC work and steel separately. Okay, so in this figure, what you have to observe is, first it is the 8 meter clear span. Observe the main bars. So here top bars, two numbers, 12 mm diameter bars. So at the innermost, four numbers, straight bars, 22 mm diameter bars. Then two bent up bars plus two bent up, means totally four numbers of bent up bars, and their diameter is also given, 20 mm diameter. These are the main bars. And next thing is stirrups. So for stirrups, just observe the mid portion. At the mid portion, spacing is 35 centimeter. Next 20 centimeter center to center. Next 12 centimeter center to center at the end on both sides. Okay, five numbers of 12 centimeter center to center on the both sides. Next four numbers, 20 centimeter center to center spacing on both sides, then 35 centimeter spacing stirrups at the mid portion. Okay, so this is regarding the steel. Okay, and 30 centimeter bearing is given here. So first we will calculate the measurement sheet is provided here. First you have to calculate RCC work. So length 8 meter clear span plus bearing is 30 centimeter means 8.6. okay, then breadth from the cross section, it is 0.4 meter and depth is 0.75 meter. It is clear from the cross section. Okay, so from this L into B into D, you will get the quantity of the concrete excluding the steel. It is 2.58 cubic meter. Okay, next you have to calculate the steel separately. Okay, first thing is go for the main bars. First one, see the longitudinal section, four numbers, 22 mm diameter straight bars, and their kg per meter weight is also given. So four numbers, it is clearly given. Okay, and straight bars there, they are provided at the bottommost. Okay, so you know how to calculate the length. Last time I have given you the general information. Okay, so first span 8.6 minus 2 end covers plus 2 hooks. So span is 8.6 effective span minus 2 end covers means 4 centimeter cover on right side, 4 centimeter cover on left side, it is 0.08 plus 2 hooks means 18 into D. D means diameter, 18 into 22 mm. So if you calculate this, you will get 8.92 meter, the total length. So 4 into 8.92, you will get 35.68 total length. Okay, if you multiply by weight, you will get the total weight, 106.33 kg. Okay, next, second is 20 mm diameter bent up bars. There are totally 4, 2 plus 2. Okay, and their kg per meter is also given, 2.47. so numbers are 4. This is the length, 9.48. so how to calculate that length? Formula is, first effective span 8.6 minus 2 end covers, that is 0.08, plus two hooks plus one depth for two pentubs. Okay, 8.6 is the clear span, so effective span minus 0.08 is the side cover, you have to minus it, plus you have to add two hooks means 18 to D. Okay, here diameter is 20 mm plus one depth for two pentubs is 60 cm because total is 65. See the cross section, it is given 65. So minus 2.5 cm top cover and 2.5 cm bottom cover. If you minus these two, you will get the distance, vertical distance between the top and the bottom bar. That is the X. So that is comes out to be 60 cm. Okay. So you will get 9.48 if you calculate this. Okay. Four numbers. If you multiply it, you will get 37.92 into its weight per kg per meter is 2.47. That is given. So you will get total weight is 93.66 kg. Next one is last one. 12 mm diameter top bars. And kg per meter run is also given for 0.89. So numbers are mentioned in the section. Two numbers, 2, and its length 8.74. So how to calculate this, the 8.74? Again the same formula. Effective span 8.6 minus 2 end covers plus 2 hooks, 18 into 12 mm. Diameter is here 12 mm. 8.6 minus 0.08 plus 18 into 12 mm. You will get 8.74 meters. Same formula you have to apply. Okay. So, two numbers into 8.74, the length, whatever you have calculated, it comes out to be 17.48. And multiply by the weight, kg per meter, you get the total weight 15.56 kg. Okay. These are the main bar. Now, we will move to the stirrups. So regarding the stirrups, see the longitudinal section, there are three types of spacings. 10 mm diameter bars at 0.62 kg per meter at the end on both sides, it is 12 cm center to center spacing on both sides, and if you count it, it is 5 numbers on right side, 5 numbers on left side, 2 into 5 means total 10. And if you calculate the length of the stirrups, how to calculate the length of the stirrups, total length? So, I have given you the formula. 2 into 2 sides, 65 one side, other side 65 into 2. Here it is 32, means 40 minus side covers, 4 centimeter, 4 centimeter side cover. So, it comes up to be 32, 2 sides into 2, plus 2 hooks, plus extra length. Okay, so 65 into 2 means 1.3 plus 0.64 plus 18 into 10, 18D, 2 hooks means. Okay, 18 into 10 mm diameter here, and extra length is 30 cm means 0.3. You will get 2.42 meter. Okay, so total is 10, 2 into 5, okay, into 2.42. Next, at 20 cm center to center, if you count it, it is 4 numbers on right side, 4 numbers on left side. But here, spacing is 20 cm center to center. And its weight is given 0.62 kg per meter. So, 4 into 2, both sides. Okay. And its length is same. Whatever you have calculated so far, same length you have to take, 2.42. So, 4 into 2, this is 8 numbers. Length is 2.42. So, total is 18. 10 plus 8. 18 into its length is 2.42. You will get 40.32. Multiply by the weight, kg per meter. So, total weight will be 27.01 kg. Okay. Next, at the mid portion, central portion. Central portion, how to calculate the central portion? Total clear span is 8 meters. So, 5 numbers of bars, 12 mm spacing. Next, 4 numbers of bars, 20 cm spacing. Okay, on one side. Similarly, on the other side. So, central portion or mid portion equal to 8 meter minus 5 bars into 12 centimeter center at the end, and on both sides means into 2 minus 4 bars of 20 centimeter center on both sides means into 2. If you deduct these two from 8 meter, you will get 5.42 meter. That is the mid portion, central portion. If you divide the central portion 5.2 meter by spacing, that is given 0.35, you will get the number of bars, that is 14. So number of bars is 14 in the central portion, and length is same. Already you have calculated length of the stirrup 2.42, so you will get 33.88. If you multiply by kg per meter, means weight is given 0.22, so you will get the total weight 7.45 kg. So total from main bars and stirrups, total weight of the steel is 250.01 kg. It is nothing but 2.5 quintal. Okay. So this is the regarding the estimate of quantity of the beam. Okay, here quantity is concrete and steel. Suppose if the rate of the concrete and the rate of the steel is given, suppose 675 per cubic meter is rate for RCC work and 515 per quintal the steel rate, then you have to form the abstract of the estimate cost if rate is given in the prompt. So it is very simple. Okay, RCC work already you have calculated the quantity, so multiply this quantity by the rate. Okay, 2.58 into the given rate per cubic meter, 675 per cubic meter, so you will get the total cost 1714.50. suppose in the end for steel bars, if the rate is given per quintal 515, so total quantity is 2.5 quintal into 515, so you will get the total cost of the steel 1287.50. So add these two, then you have to add 5%, means 3% for contingencies and 2% for work charge establishment. That comes out to be 150. So add these two, this is the grand total cost 3152.00. Okay, so if the rate is given, then only you can prepare the abstract of the estimated cost. Okay, goodbye.